Juhi is an experienced soft skill trainer and HR consultant, imparting soft skills and functional trainings to working professionals, management graduates, engineering graduates, and postgraduates, and school students. She possesses overall 15 plus years of corporate and soft skills coaching and training experience. She is a management postgraduate in human resource and international business from Center of International Business, Amity University. She started her career with Reliance Industries in human resource and possesses experience across various HR activities, majorly into learning and development, employee engagement, and organization development. She has also been associated with top organizations in telecom and travel. This experience has helped her make her programs practical and result-oriented, and she's able to understand the ground issues faced by participants. Since becoming a soft skill trainer, her work life has become more varied and challenging than she could ever have imagined. Her work has involved design, delivery, facilitation, and coaching. She has empowered and trained more than 5,000 individuals in the areas of behavioral skills. She has conducted workshops at various renowned universities, colleges, educational institutions, and corporate houses. And also she has conducted several open workshops. So I welcome you, Juhi. And today, Juhi is going to share with us about her journey of developing e-learning module. So over to you, Juhi, now. Juhi, you are on mute.
Yes. Thank you, Padul, for such a beautiful introduction, and it's overwhelming. And thank you, Hariharan sir, for giving me this opportunity to share my experience and my journey with creating an e-learning program. Now, after having two amazing speakers and an energetic award ceremony and the launch of the Skill Masters program, I just hope that I am able to justify the expectations of not only my mentors, Mr. Hariharan Iyer and Mr. Dilip Sharma, but also our esteemed delegates who have been us till now. Now, without taking much of the time, let me just come to the topic given to me. So the topic for me is my tryst with e-learning. And ever since Hari sir told me that I have to share my experience and journey of putting up an e-learning module, trust me, I haven't slept well. So thank you, Hari sir, for giving me numerous sleepless nights. Well, that was on a lighter note. The reality is that I cannot thank him enough for pushing me to create my very first e-learning module. Now, I don't have a planned PPT for this talk, and I'll keep it short and crisp since we are already at 1:10. I would be sharing my journey through a RAR model. So in this RAR model, I would basically be sharing about my journey from reluctance to acceptance for staying relevant. So starting to share about my own reluctance. Now, why I am, first of all, I am sharing my journey because soon or at least after this trainers conclave, and we expect that all of you now moving ahead, and we've seen that in Dilip sir's presentation, we have heard Hari sir also, that how e-learning is going to be the new age training methodology. So sooner or later, we have to adapt to it. Like suddenly we had to adapt to the virtual training platforms in 2020 after the COVID. But now moving ahead, we have to think that how can we stay relevant? And to stay relevant, e-learning is the answer. So starting with reluctance, I would first like to ask a question. Any wild guesses on how much time I took to create my first e-learning module? Any wild guess? Anyone?
1 month.
Yeah, that's a very interesting question, I must tell you.
1 week, 6 months, 1 month.
A week. Oh, if she had done it in 1 week, I'd have given her the Bharat.
So, 1 month. 1 month, okay. So, without taking much time, let me reveal. I took 12 months of motivation and 48 hours of development.
12 months of motivation and 48 hours of development.
So, you see, that was the reluctance. That was the level of reluctance. So in May 2020, I myself contacted Hari sir and Dilip sir after an interesting webinar that and a demo session of LMS, that how e-learning is the way forward. So I contacted them. I asked them that I want to create my own e-learning module, and they guided me. They had an orientation, and after the orientation, my excitement went from this to this. Now, there were reasons. The reason was not because how they oriented. The reason was my own self-rejection and my reluctance that how will I create a module? It would be like I have to record myself. Now, converting an 8-hour program to an e-learning module, there were many thoughts running. So few of the thoughts were that, will I be able to do justice in creating that module? How will I be able to convert the offline content to an e-learning module? The biggest fear was to face the camera. That is, able to record the videos correctly and story type it. Because here, as trainers, we have been trained since our, I would say, at least on my behalf, that since my study time, since my post-graduation time, we have been trained that as a trainer, you have to interact with your audience, you have to create an engaging environment, you have to ask questions. But here is the flip side. Here you don't see the audience. So it is like you are a prime time anchor or a radio jockey interacting with your audience, where you cannot see their expressions, you cannot read their body language. And if I go about the Albert Mehrabian's model of communication, that 55% is what is all about your body language. And here you don't know what would be the body language. So that was the biggest fear. Now, choosing the words. Again, because your voice, your tone, that has the next 38% impact. So having that, creating that impact was the next fear. So all these fears, time and again grew. And I would like to share that I was, yes, in my mind, I was clear that, yes, this is the forward path, because the more I interacted within the fraternity, with my HR colleagues, with my seniors, I knew that e-learning is the way forward. And with the corporate professionals interacting with them, there are already many large organizations who have totally shifted to e-learning trainings. So in certain organizations, at the moment, there is no offline, no online, no virtual training. It is only through e-learning. So that was the importance. So in spite of understanding that importance, that reluctance was there. And hats off to Hari sir, hats off to Dilip sir, that they kept on motivating me by sharing their own experiences. And Hari sir, on the go, like he said, he can create videos like anything. In a day, he can create 3 or 4 modules, I can say. So that was the level I was being motivated with, and I had to reach that level. So that was another fear, that I have to reach that level, that I should be able to create that many programs. So, but the consistency of motivation, the consistency of guidance Hari sir and Dilip sir were giving me, it was out of the box. And then Hari sir announced that we are having this trainers conclave, and Juhi, you have to be the speaker, and before you speak, you have to create your e-learning module. So then I said, okay, let me take it as a challenge. Let me accept that. And now that I understand, and after, in fact, listening to Dilip sir in our previous HR conclave, where he shared similarly about the magic of e-learning, it was much more clear that this is what the way ahead is. So this was the light bulb moment for me, that now it is time for me to accept it. Now, once the acceptance came, there were another folds. So next thing was that how to decide that what e-learning module should be created first. So first of all, I would say that Dilip sir there first guided me that, Juhi, whatever topic you pick up, the only sole purpose of the e-learning module should be that by the end, a learner is able to complete your module, he or she is able to go with some impact and he is able to implement it. So it is not only that you are delivering a module. It is not only that they have to run through a module. The efficiency would come that how they are implementing it. So it should be easy enough. It should be simple, yet engaging. So all with all these tips, I thought of starting my first module with the exposure I've been having for the longest duration. And that was into HR. And since HR's first step is manpower planning and recruitment and selection, so I thought of picking up a topic like interviewing skills. Now, the next block was how to convert the offline training module into an online training module. Again, the mentorship of Hari sir and Dilip sir, they guided me that it is not necessary that if you are delivering an 8 hours module, for example, in an offline scenario, you need to create an 8 hours module online also. So like Harisa said, in LinkedIn, you have various timelines. You have various duration of programs. So you can create your online modules where you can include and combine several tools. So you can have facilitation-led videos. You can also use external videos similarly as we use in offline trainings and we lead the debriefing through it or the learning through it. You can include some assessments. You can include some activities in an engaging manner. So ultimately keeping in mind that yes, the learner has to first learn that how to implement it the moment he completes the module. So with all these things, it became very easy. And the total duration after the working on the program flow, the total duration of the videos which we recorded was hardly 2 hours. And the module has now come up in a 5.5 hour duration where I have included few activities, few projects, few self-assessments. And I have done a pilot with one of my friend and she is happy that she is able to learn something new out of it. So it is also very important to do a pilot first before putting it across to your learners so that you can have some feedback. You always have your mentors there who are able to guide you. And when you are creating an engaging experience, it is like you can again keep in your mind the VAP theory that your e-learning module should have all three elements of visual, auditory, and kinesthetics. So visual is through the videos or through the reading material or through some PPT if you want to share. The auditory, again, you can use audio visuals or you can have your own videos. And kinesthetic is putting your learners across going through some self-evaluations. So I'll give you an example here. So for example, in an offline training module, we do an activity in this interviewing skill where we give a sample JD and some sample CVs to other participants. And they scan the JD on the parameters and they see the fitment of the CVs. Now I have converted this activity into an online assessment also. So in the online assessment also, JD and sample CVs are given and they have to again do the similar activity in an Excel format. Now, since it is a hybrid model, as a trainer myself, I am involved in assessing those assessments. So as a hybrid model on Bloom, we can also build it up where you can have a training module first, whereby the learners go through the module in the duration specified, and then you can have a live webinar also. So it is also important as an e-learning trainer developing yourself that you identify the right platform. The right platform should be user-friendly enough. And although I had an opportunity that I would have given all this stuff to Dilip sir and he would have uploaded it, he motivated me that Juhi, no, you take this experience, you upload the module yourself, you edit the videos, so that you get that experience of creating further modules. And trust me, the moment my first module was ready, I got motivated enough to create the next modules and next programs. And now it becomes very easy to create the e-learning programs. So this was all about the acceptance. Now, quickly about the relevance. In fact, I would not actually want to share more about much about the relevance, as Dilip sir has, Hari sir has already shared. But here I would like to just share some facts which I came across few days ago, which has made me strong on the belief that yes, if we now have to succeed as a trainer, then we have to upskill ourselves as an e-learning trainer. So like Dilip sir has already shared that by 2026, the global learning industry is projected to reach $3.3 trillion. Other surveys have brought out certain aspects, like 50% of HR decision makers said that ongoing e-learning has a direct effect on boosting employee morale. Now, we are working with Generation Z and the millennials, and they are always on smartphones. So it is important to create a learning environment where they can have, and they can have the convenience of learning as per their pace. So if I go back to the adult learning principle, that you need to create a content which is self-paced, e-learnings would be the appropriate answer to that. Apart from that, some people have, so everyone has their own learning time. So if I talk about myself, I'm much comfortable if I have to learn something new during the night hours. Some people are comfortable during the early morning hours. But if I talk about the offline training scenarios, now in the offline training scenarios, what happens is that you are called from your workstation, you have to gather somewhere. Although that's an amazing experience and a very different experience, but still, at times you have some deadlines to manage. So employees, sometimes they come with a mindset that where they are mentally at their workstation, but physically they have to be in the training room. So e-learning would be a solution to that also. So this is how I would like to, since we are already closing the time. So I would like to say that this is how you as a trainer also should kill your reluctance, build your acceptance to stay relevant. And with mentors, have your mentors, choose the right mentors, choose the right platform. And the mentorship, the kind of mentorship Hari sir and Dilip sir has given me, I am sure that soon many trainers also would be coming up with their e-learning modules. And for that, Hari sir has already lined up a webinar this Thursday. So we would request everyone that if you are thinking of leveraging yourself in the future, then please do join that webinar. So without taking much time, thank you, Hari sir. Thank you, Dilip sir. I would like to take this opportunity on this live platform and in front of all this audience to thank you enough for the motivating me, pushing me hard to create that e-learning program. And after that very first program, now I'm motivated enough that I can create many such programs.